This video provides an overview of the Lumin dashboard in Tenable.io. You can use Tenable Lumin to quickly and accurately assess your cyber exposure risk and compare your health and remediation performance to other organizations. Lumin uses a variety of metrics to help you understand where you are exposed, where you should prioritize remediation, how you are reducing risk, and how you compare to others. There are three main widgets on the Lumin dashboard. First is the Cyber Exposure Score. Cyber Exposure Score is a result of specific data science which quantifies the overall risk for your entire organization. This overall risk is calculated on a variety of factors which will be discussed in another video. This widget contains three scores related to cyber exposure. You receive a score for your organization, as well as an average score for your peers within the same industry, as well as the greater population of Tenable.io users. This allows you to compare yourself to others and provides a bit of extra context to the score. In simple terms, the higher the score, the higher your risk. This chart is interactive and allows you to get more data by clicking on your score. Here you can see a breakdown of the asset and vulnerability mix as related to their criticality. The cyber exposure score trend provides trending data about your cyber exposure score over time. This is helpful to see at a glance whether or not your score is improving or regressing. In addition to your trend, you can see whether or not your peers and the greater population are improving in relation. You can hover over individual data points for more information. The cyber exposure score by business context widget is very useful for mapping groups of assets to a cyber exposure score. Properly using tags to categorize assets will help tremendously when trying to understand assets that may be driving your score in the wrong direction and presenting unwanted risk to your organization. Looking at the breakdown, we can see that the Berlin office has a very high cyber exposure score, even though there are only 6 assets within it. Let's look deeper to get more detail. The first table represents vulnerability severity mapped to asset exposure score. The action links make it easy to understand what needs to be done in order to reduce risk across assets. Let's look at the actions for assets with a high exposure score. As you can see, applying these patches will remediate 770 vulnerabilities in the Berlin office and greatly reduce the cyber exposure score. Vulnerability age gives you an overall view into the patching cycle of the organization. Vulnerabilities that do not get patched have a higher likelihood of being exploited. The asset criticality rating chart shows what percentage of assets fall into their respective categories, from the most important to least important to the operation of the business. Asset scan distribution is an important metric for data quality. In order to achieve the highest possible data quality, aim for a high percentage of authenticated and agent scans. Finally, to ensure the data is up to date, the asset scan frequency simply identifies how often data is being gathered on your assets. Gathering current, accurate data is critical to assessing your risk.